are gone! Whoever took it, I swear! This vestige, it marks where Catrin fell. She was a lamp-bearer, like you. But far more than that, she was my love. I left a token here, in her memory. A pendant I gave her a long time ago, and now it's gone! It's all I have left! Catrin and I were both hallowed sentinels. It's hard to imagine now. She was astounding. We fell in love, and we embraced what we had, even though the Order forbids it. They found out and made sure we paid for our sin with agony. In the end, they thought we were dead. But it was only Catrin's heart stopped, and not for long, thanks to the Umbral Lamp. But even as a lamp-bearer, eventually there came a day when she fell and didn't rise again. I'll find the bastard who took that pendant. You find them first, you tell me. Understand? There'll be blood for this desecration. I'll find the bastard who took that pendant. You find them first, there'll be blood for this desecration. I know the journey here was arduous, and that since arriving in Mornstead, we have suffered much. But take heart, for are we now not within reach of Adir himself? Do we not walk among the Rolgar, our most holy brothers and sisters, born of Adir's very own divine marrow? Those heretical servants of the betrayer, Judge Cleric, may have driven us into the shadows, but are we not used to being condemned and hunted simply for our beliefs? Rest assured. Finally, the time of Adir's righteous return is nigh, and we who have remained faithful will be here to witness him usher in his glorious second reign.
I've never been too fond of fire. My grandfather used to tell stories about the Pardamish Crusades, and there was one about what the Dark Crusaders did to every man, woman, and child in one small village. That left an impression. They may worship Aureus, but it's clear as day why Judge Cleric parted ways with the Church of Orion Radiance. I've never been too fond of fire. My grandfather, and there was one to every man. That left an impression. They may work why Judge Cleric part.
Ravager's Rosary. While the Dark Crusaders have never established a formal presence in Mornstead, as you can see, our reach knows no bounds. As a former Ravager himself, Imperator Jacob would be pleased to see this return to the Aphotic Sanctum. This land is overflowing with sin. So I expect this undertaking to offer you little difficulty. Also, say nothing of this to Pietà or the Fidelis Captain. They are already conflicted. Troubling them further only endangers them and our mission. You serve a higher purpose, Crusader. Strive in darkness, in light we walk.
Radiance, judgment. Our Immaculate Lady will bring redemption.
Hello again, friend.
Chosen bearer of the lamp, like you, I serve.
Best watch your step out there. Mornstead is a land awash in blood, both deserved and undeserved alike.
But if in doubt, you heed the captain. He's never steered me wrong, much as he might think otherwise.
So, the tablets are all here. Just one more left, human.
Traveler, there is often no greater misjudgment than power being placed in the hands of one unfit for it. And Gerlinde's calloused hands and heart will only bring misery with the power of the runes. The final tablet. Bring it to me, and I...
No funny ideas, you treacherous dog. Remember, as long as you're wearing those manacles, if I die, you die. Gerlinde's already learning so much. She'll see those idiots back in Sturlevo chalk on their words.
Another like you, roads Mornstead, traveler. A man I encountered long ago. One already burdened then. A burden which has only increased enormously in the years since. And taken a heavy toll. And prolonged exposure to that obscure force so baneful to humanity. And his is a bleak, ruinous road.
Enough chit-chat. There's work to be done. Ah, you again.